It's time to export the knowledge. In this video, we'll be talking about types of data, but first, what is data? Data is just some sort of information that we have collected to explore or understand something. There are two types of data, categorical and numeric data. Categorical is self-explanatory. You have some sort of data that you collect in categories, for example, blood pressure readings. You have various levels, high, medium, low. These are just categories. Another sort of category is someone's favorite color. Numeric, on the other hand, deals with strictly numbers. Things like how long do you watch TV or how tall someone is. Now, both of these categories of data get split further into other categories. So let's start with categorical. Categorical is split into ordinal and nominal. Ordinal speaks for itself. It's something that has order. Think things like low, medium, high. There is an order that you can rank these categories. Things like color have no such order. You can't just put red before blue or vice versa. That's where the second category comes in, nominal. Nominal is something that has no order. Things like eye color are nominal. Another example could be what type of phone you have. There's no real way to order phones. You may think that a phone is superior to someone else's, but that's an opinion. This is mathematics. This is unbiased. Back to numeric data. Numeric data is split into these two categories, continuous and discrete data. These types of data aren't as obvious as categorical data types, but you can think of continuous as a line that is continuous. It stretches on forever. Continuous data is something that you can measure. When you have a measuring tape, that tape could theoretically go on forever. You just keep adding more tape. What you do to that tape is you read some value off of it. There'll be one particular value on that line that you're after. For example, height. Height is just something that we measure. We measure how tall someone is. One particular point on a continuous line. It's possible for someone to be 1.83 meters tall, for example. Discrete, on the other hand, is something that you can count, so we have whole numbers. The number of people in a class, for example, you can't have half a person. You can't have 0.1 of a person. You either have some whole number of people or no people at all. Something that I can count is what discrete data is. The number of phones that you have owned in your lifetime is a countable number. Now, there are some tricky examples. Think about postcodes. Can I get two postcodes and average them and get an average postcode? No, I don't. I can't do that. Why can't I do that? Postcodes, although they are numbers, they are not numeric data. This is categorical data. Melbourne's postcode, for example, is 3000. That particular area is categorized as the postcode 3000. Units is also very important to distinguish what kind of data you're dealing with. Let's say I conduct a survey of teenagers in Australia, and I asked, how regularly do you watch TV? Some of the time, most of the time, or all of the time. Is time spent watching TV categorical or numerical data? Well, the key here is what sort of units I've used. There is some sort of categories that I'm asking teenagers to put themselves in. So this must be some kind of categorical data. Opposed to time spent in hours, time spent in hours would be numeric data. What if I wanted to go deeper? What kind of categorical data is time spent watching TV? Well, if you look at the three options, they do have some sort of order to them. So this must be categorical ordinal data. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below or contact me on social media, and I will see you in the next video.